John, Friday, 15th August 2014. Just an update on what's happening in Britain with the Queen, and the video I watched of George Bowden, Gordon Bowden, and George Lee discussing what has happened since the Queen has cleaned out HM Treasury of all the money, the gold, I guess, it's gone. But that doesn't change the fact that we are still the beneficiaries of the trust that she's the head trustee of. And that includes Prince Andrew, trustee, and the King and Queen of Spain as trustees. Four trustees. It's a big issue. I just want to explain what we intend to do here in New Zealand. This is where the trust was set up in 1844 with Queen Victoria leading on from King William the Fourth. The connection there is that he had 50 years in the Navy in Plymouth, Devon Port. So we have intentions of going there to seize on the property against the Queen, Elizabeth. Elizabeth Windsor, to the people in Britain, you should know that she has abandoned you people and all the Commonwealth for her own private contracting business. As you can see now, she's got deals with China. We're reading the news, the latest news of her purchasing as a corporation. So it's very easy to bill her against all her estates now that she's a private woman in business, not a queen as such. It looks on the face of it. The people are fooled, and you should know, should wake up now, the British and also our country here, New Zealand, Australia, America, Canada, they should be well aware you have a fraudster in the midst with David Cameron not replying to our letter, requesting the flag of King William be raised as his ancestor. He's not doing that because he's been shut down by the Jesuits. One by one, they will fall, and their plan to poison the world and kill everybody while they go underground is at an end. As of now, since the Queen abandoned Westminster. So now that leaves Alex Salmond in a precarious situation that he needs help from us here as a contractor to Queen Elizabeth the Fourth as our trustee. We're going to sack. We're going to come there. We're going to do it online first from here in New Zealand. We can write out the King's orders. And that's what I'm charged to do as of right, as the partner, the commercial lien mortgage trading bank partner to King William. So that's our documents you see on Facebook, admissible in the High Court of Admiralty in London. They won't allow it here in New Zealand because they're fraud. The courts, the police, we have to see. They have admitted their wrongdoings with Tuhoi, one of our tribes, in exercising the federal court-martial acts without authority. They don't have authority. So I'm just saying, in this video, to Aaron Pascoe in Auckland, that we are going to seize 61 Cook Street next week at the same time, because we have the properties in England that belong to the Queen, no more. We're going to seize all her estate, church and state, all her properties, because she has committed fraud and has a warrant on her head from the World Court Tribunal for her arrest as a criminal fellow. Okay? So we have our warrant on her as well from the King's Bench. Search and seizure warrants that you see on Facebook. Those are real. I just want to express our authority, our jurisdiction of Admiralty Court Martial to act on the King's orders that we are doing at the present time, myself and Jamie, acting as a magistrate and marshals to issue order to Gordon Bowden, George Lee, John Patterson and Matt Taylor. They are the four that I've nominated from here in New Zealand with myself, John Wanoa, Jamie Patrick Stewart Ngātai, Desmond Wanoa and Dean Murray. The four here and the four in England. I'll be putting legal documents together today to tie us together in a partnership in Westminster as of today. Taking over the trust that the Queen is the head of. She has abandoned Westminster and we are going after her and her affiliates and anyone as accessories to her fraud, including the government here in New Zealand. John Key, this one's for you, and Chris Fullerson, Crown Corporation Company from Ngātua Ewa Aotea Limited. That's our company here. And we've got a company for registering in England, in London, called Moai Powerhouse Group Limited. Okay? So that company will be operating there in Brighton and Sussex. So Sussex is where the Bank of England, we're going to print the pound note against the levy debtors. Okay? Just one more time. Because the bill of the OPPT was foreclosed on the World Bank, 1141 900 million trillion US dollars, converted into British pound sterling in gold bullion. So we're going to print against the debtors. So you know, Queen, all the property that you hold belongs to us. Our partnership with the British immigrants here in New Zealand, we will be taking over from the round table. They're called the Initiative New Zealand Company. All those companies, corporations, are going to get a bill from us and our partners, legal partners in England, the four people I've mentioned, they know what they're doing, and the group with them as well, Rita Taylor and all that group that we join, Jamie and I and Desmond, and put Dee Murray in it as well. So there's four of us joining your group there. We have British citizenship under our flag, under our Declaration of Independence, King William sovereignty flag. Okay, so we do have the right to put that into acts in Westminster with Salmon, and we'll force the issue against Prime Minister David Cameron. You're listening to this video. You fail to answer our important letters to respond. Now, today, David Cameron, Prime Minister, I will write to you one more time. I'll give you 72 hours to respond. If you don't respond, we have the legal right to seize everything the Queen owns, everything the Rothschild banks have linked themselves to the fraud Queen Elizabeth or Elizabeth Windsor, and also the Vatican Church, Vatican City Company, City of London Company, and the Queen's companies, Buckingham Palace, and Queen Elizabeth II. That's another company. So all those companies with the bodgy names, we're going to write them all down from there. I know that George Lee has a good handle on who's who in companies that are running and changing their name, and along with the paedophiles. So we are going to close in on them. With the public watching this video in England and the UK, Britain, you have a fraudster on your hands, the Queen of England and the Commonwealth, and her royal family. The whole 300 royal families are now subject to levy against their debtors in our online Facebook High Court of Admiralty under King William IV, jurisdiction of Admiralty. Okay? Just to let you know that we are serious in our allegations against anyone who we name and put into the dock box. These four people have the right, the legal right, to do the same, because they are now our partners. We chose them. And we're going to let them pick two trustees out of their four. And Jamie and I, the trustees here, I'm going to replace the Queen as the head trustee of our indigenous native hapu here in Aotearoa, New Zealand. So that's the original 1844 trust with Queen Victoria, set up for us, between us and Britain. So now we have appointed four people in England to join us, to go to Westminster Parliament and challenge David Cameron. You're watching this, and your position, your legal position, is now on tenterhooks. And Philip Hammond, the Secretary of State, Foreign Affairs Minister of the Commonwealth, you're on notice now, both of you. You're on notice from me, John Hoani Kahaki Wanoa, as the King's partner, first party, King William IV, and Queen Victoria, and then Queen Elizabeth, to me, as the second party. Okay? There's the third party, is you, David Cameron, and Philip Hammond. You're a third party. You have no legal right to speak ahead of us as the first and second party to this contract. There's a private contract going on here in Admiralty law. We have the jurisdiction over you and the Queen over you, because you're only a head of state and a broken one at that. Okay? So, Queen, you've got a problem.